Stanford University.
What we've done here is figured out how to design a radio in which everything, all the functionality of radio, is integrated on a single silicon chip, which is a few millimeters on the side. That includes the antenna devices, the synchronization, computation, communication, everything on a single chip. And we've done power harvesting, where the device actually recovers and harvests power from the incoming signal, computes, and communicates back using very narrow pulses and 60 gigahertz frequency. Now, the advantage of moving to this architecture is that we can have the scalability that we want. We can scale the number of radios to thousands in a very dense environment. We can also have, because there's no battery connected, there's essentially no lifetime associated with these devices. As long as the signal is coming in, they can recover the power, communicate, and communicate back. And the cost is extremely low because we're talking about a few millimeters of silicon chip, which is a few cents to manufacture on the large scale. So we've basically rethought designing radio technology from grounds up, and we've kind of designed the technology that can scale in numbers and size. This is the next wave of wireless devices, and that's what people call Internet of Things, or some people call Internet of Everything. And this is where internet moves from your mobile devices, from your tablets and your cell phones, into everyday objects. And these objects will start making decisions based on minimal supervision, because they have wireless connectivity, they have some kind of sensing, they have computational power. You'll have these on your coffee maker, you'll have it on your fridge, and decisions and communication between these objects will enable a whole new wave of functionality, and a whole new wave of how we interact with the objects around us.
For more, please visit us at stanford.edu.